It's a weird story. I guess we have time for it. I was in college at the time. I had just started at KCC, and I was doing some independent voice acting on the side, like indie games and audio dramas and stuff like that. And one of my friends was looking at Funimation's website, and it said that, hey, they were accepting voice demos for actors. And I was like, oh, that's cool. So like, he sent me the link. He's like, hey, you should totally, you know, send your demo in and stuff like that. So I was like, sure. So the guidelines were, you have to be 18 and over. And I'm like, oh, I'm in college, I'm 18 and over. That counts. The second one was, you have to be local to the Dallas-Fort Worth area. And I'm like, that's definitely not me. But, you know, I mean, for those of you who are in college, you guys can understand, like, there's this point where you're just like, I don't know what I want to do. You know, like, I have the rest of my life to consider, and this choice of, like, what I'm going to be is going to affect it. So I thought, well, I'm going to audition. What have I got to lose? I'm young. And what are the chances that someone's actually going to contact some dude from on a rock in the middle of nowhere, right? So I made a demo, you know, polished it up, tried to make it as professional as possible. I sent it in and didn't think anything of it. And then someone from Funimation contacted me.
They're like, oh crap, why?
Do you guys know Leah Clark? She's Blair in Soul Leader. She is the one who contacted me and was like, hey, I heard your demo and you have a lot of potential. Would you be interested in auditioning? And I'm like, this has to be a practical joke. There's no way this can be real. I've never heard of this happening to anybody. And so, and she's like, no, that's not essentially what it came down to though was that even though they liked what they heard, they couldn't cast me in anything because I wasn't local. Because I couldn't, like in case they needed me to fly out or whatever at a moment's notice. You guys know how expensive it is to fly out from Hawaii to go to anywhere, right? Like, can you imagine if you spent all that money to go there to record for a show, flew back, and then they were like, hang on, we forgot to record a couple of lines. Can you fly back out? That would be so inconvenient and just not efficient. And so, essentially it came down to them saying, well, if you're ever in the area, please let us know, but we can't offer you any work. And I was like, cool. So I talked about it with my family and my friends for a bit, and I was like, "This I've never heard of this happening to anybody. This seems like a kind of a waste of an opportunity, you know? And so I had some leftover graduation money, and I was like, all right, I'm gonna take a trip to Texas, see what it's like, and if there's any way this can work out, maybe, but I wasn't really hopeful. So I flew out there, I contacted them, said, hey, I'm gonna be here for a week. If you wanna schedule some sessions, that'd be great. And so we did a bunch of, like, you know, bit parts in the wall, like background characters and crowd stuff. We just did a bunch of sessions like that. And at the end of my session, I was signing papers, and Leah Clark turned to me and she goes, when are you coming back? And I went, oh, you're serious. That's wild. And she's like, I can't promise that you'll get work here, but I think you have the potential to have something here. And I thought, I don't know. Like, that's such a risk to just up and move from Hawaii to Texas with no backup plan and just cross your fingers and be like, well, I hope it works out. I said, you know, I appreciate that, but I don't, and especially like leaving my friends and my family behind, it's not like they were gonna move with me.
Right.
I would have to do this by myself. So I was like, thank you, I'll consider it, but I don't think I can actually just make that choice. That's a very extreme move, realistically speaking. And so I went back, and then the day I got back, I got a call from our talent coordinator at Funimation being like, hey, so a couple of directors want to try you out. When are you available? And I was like, I'm out of town. It's like, when are you coming back? I'm like,
I'll get back to you.
After just, you know, really discussing it with my family and being like, is this the right choice and whatnot, I decided I'd take that risk. And I packed up, moved to Texas, and they've called me back ever since.
Oh, thank you, yes. And now I'm a voice actor for Annie Moon.